Good afternoon. My name is Melanie Warner, and I would like to welcome you to this edition of MCTV, Mississippi College's weekly news broadcast. With the University Place apartments open for students this year, we decided to take a look inside and see how this year's residents are liking MC's newest on-campus housing.
This school year, students get to experience a brand new addition to campus housing. I talked with a couple of students to hear what they thought about the new University Place apartments.
I'm now at the UP, University Plaza. There's a lot more space as well, and we also get to be with three roommates. It's just nice. It's a great way to hang out with friends and have them over and stuff like that. And also, I feel like we're getting the real college experience with the apartments.
It's better than the dorms for sure.
We have our own kitchen.
Yep.
We can make our own food.
Better than the calf.
Even with all the praise, there were still some concerns from the students.
People like to push the panic button, and it locks everyone out of the building. That's fun.
The only bad thing is the walk. We don't like to walk, but I can deal with that.
The SGA elections wrapped up last week, marking the end of a competitive campaign. The election results were given last week, and here are our freshman SGA officers. Terrence Williams as treasurer, Tia Mitchell as secretary, Jacob Moffitt as vice president, and lastly, Amy Caroline White as president. The music department is in full swing as they add the finishing touches to their musical theater production, Into the Woods. The musical will feature a cast that includes students, faculty, and staff members of Mississippi College. Performances will be held in the Gene Pittman Williams Recital Hall through October 4th. Along with the arrival of fall comes the beginning of General Rush, which can only mean one thing, Rush skits. The Rush skits are intended to give potential pledges a glimpse into the personality of the individual clubs and tribes. The event is a highlight of every fall season, and this year was no exception. And now for our question of the week. Our MCTV broadcast will offer a new question each week on a topic pertaining to things happening on campus. And here is this week's question.
Okay, what's the first thing that comes to mind when you think of the calf?
Ruska Cola.
Chocolate.
I'm kidding.
Milk.
I'm kidding. The calf? First thing that's...
Unlimited seconds.
Not unlimited seconds. Those Rice Krispie things made with Fruit Loops. You know what I'm talking about?
Tater Tot casserole.
Tater Tot casserole.
That's what you're talking about.
For supper time. Tater Tot casserole, yep. For supper time. You get all the plates you want.
All you want.
All you want. It's unbelievable.
Incredible.
Insane.
Yes.
Go Choctaws.
For our feature story, we have Hal Owens introducing the campus's newest student organization, Mississippi College Veterans Association.
Greater love has no one than this, than to lay one's life down for a friend.
Dear Lord, thank you for all you have given us. We stand today by your grace. We strive to do what is right and just in all things, though we know we may fall short. Give us strength to lead by example.
What is leadership? The U.S. Army defines leadership as loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. These seven words describe Mississippi College's newest student-led organization, the MCVA.
My name is Sam Parrish. I'm the president of the Mississippi College Veterans Association here on campus. We're an organization that's student-led, that's open to veterans, to National Guardists, to reservists, and to ROTC members.
The veterans working with the MCVA is to get them involved on campus, to help them out in other avenues.
The Veterans Association here on campus got to be a part of some pretty awesome opportunities. We hosted the Veterans Day Parade last semester, where we had Congressman Harper and Mayor Fisher come here and speak. We had a whole bunch of military vehicles, a bunch of Humvees, a big parade, flags. But also we had some pretty neat off-campus opportunities, also at the Veterans Hospital, where we sent students and veterans to volunteer at the hospital and to help with the hospitalized patients there, to pass out cards, to pass out coffee cups.
Veterans that are more active with the MCVA will not only help out the group as a whole with the campus environment, but it also helps out the community, and that's our main focus.
I'm Hal Owens for MCTV.
Such a great addition to our campus. Thanks, Hal. Now we turn our attention to MC's athletics. Andy O'Brien is in the studio to give us the latest. Andy?
Thanks, Melanie. Last season, the Choctaws returned to Division II play for the first time in nearly two decades. The transition wasn't easy, and the football team went 1-9. Although MC won't be a full D2 member until next year, talented recruits have already begun to show their skill. A year ago, the Choctaws started Coach John Bland's career at Belhaven. MC fell in the metro area matchup 32-14, but last Saturday, the Belhaven Blazers came to Clinton. They showed off their air raid offense early as Darian Thomas lays out for this 37-yard score from Clayton Webb. Raymond Cotton now in for the Choctaws, starting the drive at the 14. He's 6'5", 240 pounds. Not a small quarterback, but he can run. Raymond Cotton punches it in for six. James Banks now going to take the end around in for an 18-yard score, giving MC their first lead of the game, 28-21. Fourth quarter now, Kyle Smith back at it, picks up 44 yards here. The Choctaws are in Blazer territory. Smith led the team with 192 rushing yards on the day. Now Raymond Cotton back in. He takes a snap, runs it in from the eight, and puts MC up 35-21. And boy, it's a great day to be a Choctaw. Now the last chance for the Blazers. They haven't scored yet in the second half. Webb looks right, and cha-ching, Christian Cash intercepts it for the Choctaws. The freshman linebacker, MC, coasts to victory, 42-21. The Choctaws had 500 yards and five touchdowns on the ground. Smith was 5-for-8 with 34 yards and a score through the air. Tomorrow, the Choctaws will travel to Louisiana to take on Division I FCS McNeese State. Kickoff is set for 6 p.m., and you can listen along on Star 93.5. The women's soccer team has been doing well for MC so far. The Lady Choctaws have won 5 games, lost 0, and tied once. They've beaten Division I Jackson State 2-0, and Gulf South Conference rival Delta State by a score of 4-1. All told, they have outscored the competition 19-2. Andrea McDonald has started all 6 games in the net for the Choctaws and has made 16 saves while only letting 2 goals in.
Go Choctaws! Thanks, Andy. And once again, we would like to thank you for tuning in to this edition of MCTV. Please follow us on Twitter at Miss College TV. We'll see you later. Have a great day.